Hello Internet, I'm HamsterBomb, and you guys are back for some more Pokemon Platinum Cute Charm, and today we are moving to what might be our final route for straight-up shiny hunting, and this is excellent. I turned on my game today just to see what my swarm was, and lucky for us, it was Natu. Natus are out here in Route 224, which, like I said, is, I think, our last environment to go for. With wild Pokemon. I have to clarify, there's so many places to go, so many things we gotta do, that if I clarify it like that, yes, technically, this is the last patch of grass for grass-based Pokemon. Shiny Natu is really hard to identify, so gotta make sure that you keep your eyes peeled for this. While it is the swarm for today, it's gonna be a 40% chance, though we are going to require two of them, because of course we're gonna need a Zatu. Now, aside from them, there's several other Pokemon that we're gonna need out of here. And, we're gonna need a lot of, we're gonna be here definitely for two episodes. Maybe even three if it's a problem. But, for sure, like, I was not worried about Natu. I'm just going really quickly trying to get Natu out here. Because after we get Natu, I'm finding girls. Oh, it's because I have slots out front. I'm sorry. To get here, did anybody in the comments even notice that? I'm also streaming this episode as well, so, man. Internet didn't even point that one out to me. Actually, well, normally we're supposed to see our second Pokemon. It's kind of a hassle getting to this route. There we go, now we have magic. I was like, what? Wow, that's kind of weird. I'm seeing a bunch of males. Oh, shoot. Whoops. I totally forgot to look at the encounter. Whatever, we'll start a new one. Oh, I found a Natu anyway. That's really weird. Magic needs to get killed. So maybe Natu can actually kill me? Maybe? I'm just gonna slowly pound it to death while it kills me. Unless it uses ghost moves. Power swap? That's useless. Don't let magic kill you, I'll be so sad. Alright, what moves does it know? This isn't gonna work out. I'm never even gonna explain, like, the beginning of this episode. As well as one more thing before I forget. I know by the time this episode goes live, thank you for hitting me with Psychic, finally. Excellent. By the time this episode goes live, this is old news, but at the very least, I wanted to make sure that I congratulated this person twice over, once live with everybody who is watching right now on the stream, and secondly, when the episode actually goes up, this episode's gonna be going up, like, in January. So, anyway, for now, in the month of October, I had a shiny Pokemon Cute Charm giveaway. And the giveaway was for a free copy of Pokemon Pearl that I have personally Cute Charmified, and it's a giveaway just for free to a random subscriber who followed my Twitter page, because it had to use Twitter during that time frame. It's just a YouTube terms and conditions thing. You're not allowed to do giveaways with people who are subscribed for whatever reason. And anyway. Finally announce the winner, because obviously October is while we film this. What happened? Did I run? Did I run? I killed it, didn't I? What did I do? I'm not even paying attention. But still, there's so many Pokemon out here. It's 40%. I'm not worried about that now, too. Anyway, can't get on with this. The winner of the free Pokemon Pearl copy, normal, was Samantha Glenn. So congratulations to Samantha. I've already, actually, not at the moment, it's not physically shipped out as I'm filming this right now. We're working on it, but we're getting everything wrapped up, packaged up. And Samantha got a free Pokemon Pearl Cute Charm game. So tell everybody congratulations to Samantha. Real excited that we got a winner. And with that, I'm still, of course, doing donation-based ones, so if you guys really wanted to get a Pokemon Cute Charm game, I'm still obviously doing them, so you can still, there's videos if you go to my, my About page on the channel. There's a link to a video in there that'll basically take you to, all the instructions that tells you how to get the whole process done. Send the donation, send your game in, I Cute Charm it for you, send it back, whole shebang's cool, good to go. So, anyway. Finally gotta get back to, like, this route and what's going on out here, because there's a lot. This route is not 100% Natsu, I assure you. Though at the moment, it seems to be. Right now, it should be regular daytime. Oh, yeah, I'm on 2. I was gonna say, I read that backwards. I read 5 as our stream. Dyslexia even works with, like, mirroring images. It's really annoying. So, obviously we gotta get these 2 Natsus. Other than this, during the daytime, there's a lot of Pokemon we gotta get out here, as I said at the top of the episode. We need to find, I'm gonna go most common to rarest, okay? The most common Pokemon we can find out here is Bellsprout. We only need one, though. We have to find one shiny Bellsprout. Other than that, it starts getting really bad really quick. We're gonna need a 10% East Coast Gastrodon. Why are we not finding shiny Natu? Can anyone explain this? Okay, I don't know what's going on. But anyway, because this is what, like, near our 10th, and it's like a 21% chance of finding a shiny. I don't know what's going on. So, anyway, we got a 10% chance at Gastrodon. Not so bad. But it's basically the others. We have a 5% chance of Gloom. We need 3 shiny Glooms. Yeah, Magic's up front. Magic's just fainted, guys. Aside from the 3 5% Glooms, we're gonna need 2 5% Weepinbells. Because, of course, like I said, we only needed 1 Bellsprout. So, that is really bad. We need, I mean, that's gonna be a ton of new Pokemon out of here. That's really cool, but, just kind of stinks that, that's 4. I'll take it. It's just a Natsu. I mean, it's super common. Why are we not finding a shiny already? It's a male. What's going on? Magic is out front and fainted. I know Magic's out front. Alright, well, apparently this is actually taking me a while, so I guess I'm gonna see you guys when we get ourselves a shiny Natsu. Magic is back in the front after, yeah, because I reset the whole thing. Yes! Shiny Gloom! One encounter is all it took. Magic is working. The only problem is Magic's alive. So if you guys saw during that montage, what I basically had to do, because we were not finding shinies for some reason, I reset my game and put Magic back in the front, and in one encounter we found our Shiny Gloom. So, I don't know. I say our Shiny Gloom, but we need 3! Oh my gosh, I forgot! We need freaking 3 of them! Open link in new tab. So, let me read a bit about our little Gloom friend. At level 50 freaking 1, with a capture rate of 120, by the way. Not so bad. Yeah, this thing's gonna be almost maxed out attacks. It's gonna know Giga Drain, Moonlight, Natural Gift, and Lucky Chant. That is, like, impossible to weaken. That is so annoying. You know, 120, I really don't want to waste the Quick Ball, but at the same time, I really want to get out of here. I'm gonna try it. Just get this one over with. At the very least, I'm gonna just chuck a Quick Ball. 1. Holy crap, are you kidding me? What? No. Gloomy's Lucky Chant. You little stink. That was 1,000 Pokedollars just to throw that 1. I don't even have that many regular Pokeballs. Oh, we're in trouble. Just Pokeball, I guess. Oh my gosh, are you kidding me? I needed to kill Magic, of course, too. Please, just kill it. Can't, can it? Giga Drain me. Natural Gift, but it failed. And it's gonna Moonlight, and it's gonna fail. It's gonna Moonlight, it's gonna fail! It's gonna try to stay in a Pokeball, it's gonna fail! It's gonna fail at staying in the Pokeball, which by failing at staying in the Pokeball, it succeeded. I succeed. I caught the Pokemon. Yeah, yeah. I did the thing. I checked the thing off my list of things that needed to be did, and I did that thing. The weed Pokemon! No jokes, guys. The honey it drools from its mouth smells so atrocious it can curl noses more than a mile away. Wow. That might need a Pokedex Paradox episode. How bad can something smell? I don't think it's like the strength of the odor, not like how bad it is. But still, like, the strength of it doesn't even... How? Well, I mean, like, though, there are, like, skunks. You know, certain skunks that you can smell for, like, forever away. So, maybe I'll buy that. Maybe. Give a nickname to the Cockloon? Whew, yes. Doom and Gloom was transferred to Box 1 at Bebe's PC. Good lord. I've never had anything of such an easy capture rate just burst out of my quick ball like that. I probably have. Probably have, I just haven't paid attention. Alright, now we got some regular Glooms. I'm actually pretty happy we're on the Gloom train first, because Glooms out here... Oh, right. I need it to kill me. Oh my gosh, it's not gonna happen, is it? Oh no. Oh, this is gonna take forever. Never mind, this is gonna take forever for me to find the next one, because it has to kill magic. There we go, it's one attack. You can drain, please kill me. Dang it. Okay, this is gonna take a while. I'm gonna see you guys in the next bloom. Oh my gosh, just pointing it out. Shiny Natu is making this patch even harder to hunt in, because he's a 40% on top of all of the other stuff that's in here. It's ridiculous. Yes, he's working! Yes, it's working! I was losing my mind for a minute there. Because that bit before when we started the top of the episode and we were trying to find a Natu in the chain, that wasn't working for some reason. And we were like, magic's fainted, but magic's in the front of the party. Why are we finding no shinies? We found, like, I don't know. I'm gonna say I went, like, 20-some Pokemon straight with no shinies at all. And finally, because magic just fainted, as you guys saw before, finally we have a shiny Gloom. Thank you. This is our second of three. I don't even think I have the Sunstone or Leafstone for this. Excellent. So we're gonna go on some more adventures between episodes to try and evolve these things. That stuff comes later, and that's all the internet right now lives thing to figure out how that's gonna happen later. But for now, I gotta catch you. Gloom, to be honest, I don't even want to give you the quick ball because you ain't worth it, but at the same time, I'm running out of stuff. Oh, I should have practiced on another move, but I could have critted. To see, like, how much damage it'll do. I'm scared. We're gonna run into so much harder stuff. Ultra Balls cost even more money than Quick Balls. I'm not doing that. Fine. I'll throw it. I'm so poor in this game now. I think I have, like, I'm not joking, like, 400 Pokedollars? Yes. Thank you. It actually worked. Ugh. Someone's asking, Peppletoad Marco is asking, have I ever played Gale of Darkness? I have not. That game is actually kind of rare, kind of hard to get your hands on, and I've never found it. Well, I've seen it once. It was, like, too much money. They were asking for way too much money at, like, a used game shop, so I was like, no. But anyway, give a nickname to the cot. Gloom number two. Yes. Larpadebble was transferred to Box 1 in Bebe's PC. The internet couldn't come up with a nickname, so I did, with random letters. The end. We gotta move on sometimes. Just gotta go. Gotta frickin' go. They were all trying to go with some, like, inside joke of some other YouTubers, like, Nuzlocke or something or other, and, like, no! Stop! No! Gloom has got to die. We have 10 more side beams to go, and the problem with that is, I really need to save some for the fact that we have to still get 2 Weepinbells, so I really need a shiny Gloom fast. I don't want to. Oh, that's not a glim. That is not a glim. That again. That is the game trying to trick me. So we're already at 10 and found two glims. That's actually fair. So hopefully we're gonna find yet another gloom. No. I'm not sure if I should like stick with you guys or what, but ooh, yeah, let's not do the montage yet, because I've done it like too many times in this episode. We already gotta get going. Oh no. Maybe I should. Because it's clearly not, this isn't working. This looks like an excellent patch to chain in, but at the same time, like, I'm getting really unlucky with the direction my patches are firing in, and it's not helping at all. So, regardless, I guess I'm gonna see you guys when we get somewhere around 15. And we have another sparkling gloom. There we go. Just kidding. Maybe. No! It broke! It's a 4! Why?
Oh no!
Gloom is still a 5% rare. Oh my gosh. Oh, that patch was fine. I might as well save. Oh my gosh. Well, I have 2. Oh no. All right, here's what I think we gotta do. I think we gotta switch over. It's wild encounter time. We have to wild encounter. Oh my gosh, because Natsus are out here, and the Natsus are honestly making the Glooms and the Weepinbells even rarer than 5%, because this is an intruding 40. So, we just need to get the freaking Natsus out of the way, and the best way to do that is by giving everything else a fair shot of shining. Who knows, maybe I'll find an insanely rare Gloom that'll shine for us while I'm trying to find these Natsus that apparently just don't shine at all. So I'm just gonna be running back and forth in this grass patch, and with that, you know, just to make sure I do it and I don't chicken out, I'm gonna put the bike on. All right. Oh God. Oh God. I gotta turn it into the acro form. It gets started faster. Yes! Shiny Bellsprout! Yes! There we go. There we go. That's why we wound a counter like this. I feel a little bit better, even though that was a common. It's not a bad thing. I love my clown. Okay, I am a strong individual. I'm okay. Bellsprout, what do you know? Bellsprout, I want to learn all about you and read your LinkedIn profile before I hire you for my team. You have a catch rate of 255. I'm not even going to mess around. Pokeball, stay with me forever. You know, Bellsprout's actually a really strong Pokemon to be a 255. Wow, it just denied me. So it's going to know... Ring Out, Slam, Razor Leaf, and Gastro Acid. Fortunately, I'm not too worried about that. It's only Ring Out that might be an issue. That's actually kind of cool for Victory Bell. But we aren't going to be evolving this one at all. This one's going to stay as a Bellsprout. An insanely high-level Bellsprout. Someone's going to get it out there. Because as you guys know, I do trade with you guys when I'm done with, you know, the whole... series, I trade you guys the Pokemon that I got throughout the whole event, and I've also got a big end of game stream that I like doing with you guys too. Yes, where I basically take your all advice, and someone says like, "Hey, go shiny hunt a bunch of this Pokemon over here," and I'm like, "Okay, cool," and I go hunt a bunch of them and I collect them. Because I transfer all of them up to the main games and trade them to you guys. So, if you want a better shot at getting a certain kind of Pokemon, make sure you don't miss that upcoming stream for when the series is ending. If you see Heatran, then for sure that stream is a common. I might even do extras of that stream. Not sure yet. But, regardless, we have a shiny Bellsprout, the flower Pokemon. It prefers hot and humid environments. It's quick at capturing prey with its vines. Give a nickname to the caught Bellsprout. Yes. It's so stupid. Just Taco was transferred to box 1 in Bebe's PC. I find it so much funnier than I should. Oh, shiny Natsu, yes. This will be our last one for the episode. I've already gone over. This is crazy. But we're finally gonna get one of the Natsus today. Oh my gosh. I love the dumber the names are, the better they are. So the internet, start cooking up some really stupid names for this Natsu. We have to catch this thing. So, Natsu has a capture rate of 190, and at level 50, it is going to know Psychic Guard Swap, Power Swap, Ominous Wind. Not a really big deal. In fact, it can only hit me with Psychic right now. So, I kind of want to try the Pokeball trick again. I really should have bought more of those. Maybe after this route, what we should do is go over to the Trophy Garden, because there's a really great way to grind for money right there. And, of course you used Psychic. There's a great way to grind for money. And what I should probably do is stick around there, grind up a ton of money, buy a ton of Pokeballs, and then we can go for some Trophy Garden shiny hunts, because the Trophy Garden has like a lot of babies, which is really cool. Natsu, you're not too effective right there. Did you get my meaning? Are you a punny kind of bird? Is that the kind of bird you are? One, two, three. You like? No, he doesn't like. Okay, fine. Natsu, just saying, neither do I. Not a pun guy. In fact, I have banned people for using too many puns in my live streams. I'm not ashamed of it. I did. I feel awful, but I'm not ashamed of it. Okay, apparently that was going too far for you. Natsu, look, we need to talk. Okay, here. I won't hurt you. I'm only going to imprison you for the rest of your life and then trade you away to a random person on the internet. Is that so bad? Is freedom really worth it to you? Is it that great? I know you're swapping out your guard and your power with me. You live in a land of communism, don't you? I shouldn't be going there. But he does, he's sharing everything with me. And he won't stay. Give up your freedom! One, two, three! Freedom is gone! Yay! Let's not nickname it something communistic. That'd be terrible. Gotcha, Natsu was caught. Hooray! Hey, I did not level up to 79 before I found a shiny Natsu. That was our inside joke in the stream, and it didn't happen. The tiny bird Pokemon, it picks food from cactus plants, deftly avoiding buds and spines. It seems to skip about to move. Oh, it's cute. I'm just imagining that because I was never really, I never really liked Natsu's design because he's so simple. But now, like, watch him, like, skip just makes him so much better in my head. In fact, making almost anything skip in my head makes it better. Except Weasel. Makes me want to shoot it with, like, an AK-47. But anyway, give a nickname to the caught Natsu. Yes. P-Brain was transferred to Box 1 in Bebe's PC. And I can finally move on and save because we ended an episode. We found a lot of shinies today. Not exactly the bunch I would have expected first. I'm kind of slowly getting over the absolute horrible atrocity it was of us losing our last and final Gloom, which that was kind of redundant. My syntax needs to be a little bit more articulated better, but I'll work on it. Sorry. For the next episode, we for sure need to get our hands on a second Natsu. We still need a shiny Gastrodon East form. We need that extra Gloom and two Weeping Bells. Man, I might even be in here for a third episode. Ouch. But we'll see how this goes in the next episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to like the videos and subscribe for more, and I will see you all in the next episode of Pokemon Platinum Cute Charm.